Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. Today's my topic is orthodontic tooth movements, mechanotransduction, and how to increase tooth movements. Orthodontic appliances all involve the use and control of forces acting on teeth and adjacent tissues. An optimal force intends to induce maximal response. When a force is applied, inflammatory response started. Orthodontist tries to put light forces to minimize side effects. Whenever force is applied, there is resorption on one side and deposition on other side, so that socket will keep its shape. Bone resorption and tooth movements are directly proportional. Bone is covered by a membrane called the periosteum, which is differentiated from surrounding connective tissues. Three types of cells are involved in the orthodontic tooth movement. These are the osteoblast, osteocytes, and osteoclasts. Osteoblasts are mononuclear cells present on inner surface of bone. They are mesenchymal stem cells and they secrete factors that regulate osteoclastosis. They make collagenous and non-collagenous proteins, which is part of organic matrix of osteoid. They are basically quiescent cells until some factors like BMPs, FGFs, cytokines, interleukin-1 and hormones start their division. So these are the regulators of osteoblastic activity. Osteoblasts work in anaphase of orthodontic tooth movement. Second number of cells are osteocytes. They are immobilized in lacunae of bones and have long processes by which they are communicate with each other. There are present mechanosensors in these processes of osteocytes. So mechanical influence of differing intensities cause osteogenesis. Important thing is periosteum continue to function as an osteogenic zone throughout life, although regeneration capacity is extremely high in young child. In this response, they secrete key factors from osteocytes such as prostaglandins, nitric oxide, IGF. So they activate bone remodeling. They work in catabolic phase to activate osteoclast and in anabolic phase to coordinate osteoblasts, so they work in both. Now comes to the osteoclasts, which are the most important cells of bone resorption. They are the cells which resorb bone and they belong to monocyte macrophage system. Circulating mononuclear cells, which when fused together give multinuclear cells that also have big processes. On these processes are calcium receptors and TRAF receptors that are the tartarate resistant acid phosphatase. On one side is ruffled border also, which have proton pumps which acidify bone surface. Osteoclasts are regulated by osteoblast by RANK, RANKL, MCSF and prostaglandin. Osteoblasts control rate of bone resorption. After bone resorption, they die. Osteoclasts differentiates along alveolar bone wall after 30 to 40 hours. They never work alone, but the osteoblast give signals which control osteoclastic activation, maturation, and resorption of bone. Osteoclast control is by the osteoblast. If they don't control, then the continued activation of osteoclast will cause the severe bone resorption, which result in weakness of bone and bone fractures. Orthoforces intensity give different movements. It depends upon the force magnitude and duration. Every type of movement give us specific stress distribution PDL and bone. So osteoclast control rate of tooth movement. Application of continuous force on growth on crown of tooth leads to tooth movement. When a force apply, first osteocytes measure matrix deformation and give signal to osteoblast to resorb weak bone and to osteoblast to form new bone. When pathologic load exceeds detected by the osteocytes and remodeling on damaged site within 30 to 40 hours. The inflammatory response depends on age, the target of blood vessels constrict, the blood flow becomes less, and so the oxygen level. Some cells undergo apoptosis, some necrosed, causing self-rezone or hyalinization, which is a glass-like appearance. Cells undergo a series of changes, starting with swelling of mitochondria and the endoplasmic reticulum, and continuing with rupture and dissociation of cytoplasmic membrane. This leaves only isolated nuclei between compressed fibrous element and is the first indication of hyalinization. In hyalinized zone, no osteoclast progenitor cells can be recruited, so no bone resorption from PDL. Tooth movement stops until hyalinized tissue removed and area is repopulated by cells. A limited hyaline area occurring during light forces, which is called the frontal resorption, and persists for 2 to 4 weeks. If bone density is high, duration will be longer. Inflammation response occurs by both physiologic and pathologic one. Chemokines released from local cells. Chemokines are small proteins which attract far off cells to this area and which facilitate adhesion molecules like integrins. Now, what is mechanotransduction? This is how mechanical signal can initiate biological cellular responses. Is the mechanotransduction. Initial aseptic inflammatory response include chemokines which release initially and include MCP1, CCL2. They recruit monocytes from the bloodstream to the area where reaction is and they become macrophages called osteoclasts. CCL3, CCL5 also are osteoclast recruiters. After some time of application of orthoforces, so many mediators release, inflammation mediators. These are extracellular proteins or pro-inflammatory cytokines, which either maintain inflammation or increase to cause the bone resorption. These are the interleukin-1, TNF-alpha, interleukin-6. So basically, osteoblast, fibroblast, and endothelial cells, they are all the inflammatory regulators. Two types of mediators released from the mesenchymal cells, such as the PDL cells. These are the calcium signaling, which in turn promotes ATPase produce PGE2. This is one, and which have three functions: with vasodilation, increased vascular permeability, and cellular adhesion. Second types are the neuropeptides, which act during different stages of inflammation, and these are small proteins such as substance P, which transmit pain signals, maintain vessel tone, and modulate vascular permeability. These are all inflammatory markers which activate osteoclasts. These cells secrete cytokines which bind to their receptors and activate osteoclastogenesis. Interleukin-1, interleukin-6 indirectly stimulate cells to express MCSF, that is macrophage colony stimulating factor. The regulation of osteoclastogenesis by the osteoblast is mediated by Rank-Rankel OPG lesion receptor complex. Rankel is a protein found on the surface of osteoblast lineage cells where it stimulates osteoclastogenesis by the binding to Rank, which is receptor activated nuclear factor kappa B. Rank is a transmembrane protein located on osteoclast progenitors and osteoclasts. The binding of Rankel to Rank is essential for stimulating osteoclast formation and activity and for promoting osteoclast survival. This interaction is regulated by a soluble decoy receptor OPG, which is also secreted by cells of osteoblastic lineage. OPG acts as a competitive inhibitor of Rankel. OPG competes with Rankel for Rank and so inhibits osteoclast differentiation, its activity and its survival, and diminish osteoclastogenesis, thus stopping or decreasing orthodontic tooth movement. Lack of OPG will lead to uncontrolled osteoclastogenesis, leads to bone porosity and fractures. Now many researchers focus on how to increase orthotooth movement. As we know the basic, if we can increase the osteoclastic numbers with any source, biological response can be enhanced. Two methods are there for increase in tooth movements, either by increased release of cytokines or by increased mechanical stimulation. Some researchers focus on how to increase osteoclast numbers. The chemical agents like parathyroid hormone and thyroxine, relaxin, vitamin D3, corticosteroids, osteoclonal antibody to Rankel that also function to inhibit Rankel binding to Rank contributes to significantly diminished serum markers of bone resorption. So they reduce fracture and increase bone mineral density in menopausal adults. It was found a single injection of OPG-FC can prevent relapse of teeth and movement for up to 1 month. It can be used in encourage and relapse situations, but Because osteoclast activity is essential for normal bone physiology, use of these osteoclastic inhibitors are of limited value. If yields undesirable, then systemic effects can be worsened. So they are not risk-free. Also, these chemicals have short half-life. Now, if we come to how we can increase the tooth movement by physical stimuli like vibration, heat, light, pulse, electromagnetic currents, laser, low-level laser therapy, piezoelectric currents, slippers, all these show inconsistent results from different studies. The other one is the natural pathway by corticotomies, by piezocian, and by MOPs, that is micro osteoperforations. These are all wisely selected approaches by orthodontist according to the encouraged and biomechanical design of the case. In corticotomy, flap is raised and cuts are made on cortical bone and trabecular bone, but it has certain complications like it's an aggressive approach, it's least economic, it's time consuming, it's a long recovery time, and it should be used wisely. Second is piezocian. It's a less invasive approach and cuts are made with the scalpel on the mesial and distal side of the tooth to be moved, and then with the piezocian blade, linear incisions are made in bone, no flap raised. The third is the MOPs, that is the micro osteoperforation. In this also no flap raised and small holes are placed on the buccal and lingual plates. This is commonly used method to speed up the tooth movements.